Mike, dito sa ating alumni negosyo, salamat for giving your time na, you know, to inspire the community and to share your story. So before tayo mag-jump dun sa entrepreneurship journey mo, introduce mo muna yung sarili mo, tapos anong batch ka nang galing. Tapos magbigay ka ng isang parang pinaka-memorable kung may natatandaan ka pa sa LSE na nangyari when we were students before.
Magandang gabi, Robert. Yeah, kasi 7 p.m. na. First of all, thank you for this opportunity. For having me here in Alumni Nego Show is really a good initiative ng Ateneo LSE Singapore to have this kind of platform to be able to share and inspire people. So my name is Michael Genove. I'm from LSE Batch 47. So actually, magka-batchmates kami ni Press Robert during that time ng aming Ateneo LSE. Memorable time. Actually, there are a lot of memorable experiences, no? In terms of yung bonding talaga ng classmates, kasi we had that group during our time na we have lunch together and potluck. So it's really a good memories to look back, having that kind of friendship that until now it's still there, formed through the Ateneo LSE program. And siguro one of the memorable things dun is yung first few sessions natin was conducted in one location sa AIA. I think we were the first batch to use the bayanihan.
Tayo yung pero tayo din yung last batch na nag-school sa isang carpeted na room. Remember? That's a carpeted room.
Oo nga, magdadala ka talaga ng jacket mo pagkapapasok.
Yun nga sinasabi namin sa mga bagong batch ngayon. Although iba yung dynamics kasi nag-zoom sila online. Sinasabi namin na talagang na-miss nyo yun, yung physical na nandun kayo sa room. Andun yung iba kasi yung bonding na kahit naririnig ko, iba rin daw yung bonding nila. Pero siguro kung na-train nila yung classroom, andun talaga yung
I remember may nagbebenta pa nga ng mga mangga with bagoong.
Oo, nag-evolve ang mga bentahan.
Diba, during break time, parang yes. Part ng entrepreneurial, very entrepreneurial talaga. So, pag may product ka nun, you can sell during the after the class. So, which is really a good platform to
actually,
start.
Actually, parang practice market natin yun, remember? Parang, kung marami kang makonvince doon sa classroom natin, ibig sabihin, my product is good. I want to bring this to the mainstream market.
May market siya, yes.
Thank you for that, short parang throwback na trip down memory lane. Kailan ka ba uli umuwi ng umalis ng Singapore? Anong taon yun? Parang tagal na rin yata.
Actually, about more than a year now. We left Singapore 7th of March 2020, last year.
Akyat yung COVID pala noon, tama?
Yeah, actually, that time, no, the thinking was tumataas yung nag-amber na yata dyan sa Singapore, yung alert. Orange, was it? Yeah, tapos sa Pilipinas, parang wala pang cases. So you're thinking, parang mas magandang mag-move back na dun ng mas mabilis. So when we landed, ng March 7 dito, the second day, March 9, nag-announce na magla-lockdown ng March 16 kasi nagkaroon na ng spike of cases na dito sa Philippines. It was really an extraordinary time to move back.
Yung The Good Korean, anong pangalan na ito?
The Good Place.
Yon, The Good Place. So, is this a physical Korean mart na sinet up mo?
It has its own, we call it brick and mortar store. No? So, it is located in Quezon City, in Nova Liches. Kasi I'm actually a native of Quezon City.
can you give us like a background? Paano ba yun? Pinaplano mo ba yun na nasa Singapore ka pa? Or is it something that happened nung umuwi ka na? Can you give us like a backstory? You know, how it started? At parang kung naalala mo, kailan yung first time na naisip mo na gagawin mo talaga yun?
That business is something that just came because of the opportunity that we saw. So during that time, everyone was staying at home. Basically, wala ka talagang ibang magagawa, no? Especially ako, unemployed ako at that time because we were supposed to set up a business. So I was just staying at home. I am not reporting to any company. So Netflix was one of the things that we spent most of the time during that first lockdown. And while I'm into Netflix, watching the shows, no, I noticed meron di ba yung ranking sa Netflix yung top 10 in the Philippines. Mm. I've noticed doon na out of 10, probably you will see about 60% or 6 out of 10 or more than that, probably 7, would be like Korean dramas. It gave me an idea na the Korean culture, Korean drama is really being well embraced by the Filipino. So nakita ko na yung opportunity na yun na probably if we sell Korean products in my place in Novaliches, I think I would not have any difficulty in selling the goods. After the lockdown, we decided to move nga dito sa Angeles City, where nandito rin pala yung Korean town. So kung meron tayong Binondo Chinatown, yung Korean town is nandito naman sa Angeles City. I observed din talaga yung mga groceries, the Korean marts. Sinuyod ko yung mga Korean marts dito. I noticed na a lot of Filipinos, not only Korean population were actually the one doing the grocery, but Filipinos in general. So it really cemented the idea na, okay, since wala namang Korean mart dun sa Quezon City, where we stayed, let's try out. Kasi meron kaming isang place doon, old place ng aking parents na nobody has been using for a few years now. And meron yung space na perfect to convert into a convenience store kasi it's alongside a busy road. So, ayun. December 2020, we started. It's a very lean startup, I would say. Kasi from the garage itself, nagbukas lang kami ng gate. Naglagay ako ng table. Bumili ako ng few products that I think would be sold out by the local market. Walang Korean dun sa ano namin, sa lugar namin. And eventually, tama nga yung naging theory, no? Pagkabukas namin in 8 o'clock in the morning, wala pang 10 minutes, meron nang naglakad. May bumili agad ng soju. Doon nag-start. People were word of mouth, nalalaman na doon sa subdivision, and people were coming from different locations na, no? From Karatig na mga barangay, nearby barangays, driving to the place because they've heard someone saying that may nag-open doon ng small Korean mart. Then January, we decided na, okay, let's seize the opportunity to open up a proper convenience store. Nagpatayo na kami ng glass doors. We hired employees na, and we put up a system.
So talagang ano pala, no? Parang medyo based siya sa part na ng culture natin kay drama. I mean, ako meron ako mga magagandang napapanood din. So parang yun pala yung nag-drive sa'yo ng understanding mo of the market, no? Dahil nakita mo yung lalo ng mga Pilipino eh, na pag may nagustuhan, ibang klase pag sumubaybay tsaka sumunod talaga yun. Para alam yan, yung pagka-fanatic ng Pinoy minsan eh. So you took that opportunity. Kaya yung kwento mo na may bumili agad na soju, medyo classic yun.
I couldn't forget that kasi yun ang first sale talaga namin. Soju. 8 o'clock. Wala pang 8:15 in the morning yun talaga yung binili niya.
So saan mo kinukuha yung mga, sino ba yung supplier mo niyan? Meron kang siniship ba yan o meron parang bigger supplier sa Pinas?
I do have suppliers here direct from Korea. Kasi they do ship containers, regular containers dito sa Pampanga. At the scale of the business that I have right now, it's more economical to still get it from a local importer.
Thank you for sharing that na. Ang next ko sigurong gustong inquire sa iyo is meron kasi mga business na it requires for you to be physically in that place of business, right? Meron naman mga business na you can manage remotely. And as we understand, a lot of our colleagues and friends from the alumni, they are planning to do their business while they are in Singapore. Can you, based on your experience, is it even a good idea na, halimbawa, nasa Singapore ako or someone, and then mag-isip na gawin yung katulad ng ginawa mo? Or did they have to be physically, you know, in that location where they set up the business?
That's a very good question, Robert. And I was also in that same position when I was still in Singapore. I tried many different things, no, from farming to distribution. While I was in Singapore, and it's really the biggest challenge is actually the remote, we call it the remote management. I've learned that, the key to that, if you really wanted to succeed, is hiring the right people.
Mm-hmm.
Having that right people and the right talent to support. And it's easier said than done, you know. The biggest challenge actually that, to me, if you would ask me, it's not about funding, hindi about finances. It's not about the location. It's more about finding the right people. Again, yun nga, very difficult to find that. So if you don't have that kind of person to rely, running a business remotely from Singapore is going to be a challenge.
Sorry, kasi ano yun, no? Mag-invest ka ng trust, no? Tapos pag maling, alam mo yun, parang mali. Minsan, kamag-anak mo na eh, di ba? Hindi mo rin masasabi.
Correct, yeah. So, depende talaga sa ano mo yan, no? Babalik sa how prepared are you, yung risk appetite mo. Ang business naman, as we all know, hindi naman yan everyday smooth sailing. So, we encounter bumps during that time. What if during that time is they experience pressure? Tapos bigla ka nang iwanan sa gitna ng challenge noon, gitna ng storm that the business is going through. So wala kang mga asahan but yourself. So you really have to decide whether you have to continue hiring other people or you drop the business or drop what you're doing in Singapore and move back. Mm.
Yep.
So it is a very tricky situation. So people decide, you really have to decide what you really want to do.
I agree. Ngayon, jump tayo dun sa ano mo, yung merong kanina nabanggit natin off cam, merong anong parang Lushotan enterprise na tinatayo. Anong how is your Korean Mart related? Ikaw rin ba ang nagpapatakbo ng Waymaker?
I call it like an umbrella company, an umbrella group, Waymaker. That's actually the company that I founded first before the Korean Mart. So it has
Lushotan level nga eh.
Few divisions. I'm not trying to really spread myself very thin. No? Those areas that I could really handle. So under Waymaker, I have dun yung I have the Waymaker Marine, Waymaker Industries, which is basically it's a marine equipment and services supply company. Kasi that is where my expertise in Singapore came from. I worked in marine and offshore industry dyan sa Singapore. So I'm basically continuing that kind of business here in the Philippines. So meron siyang another sister company. I call it the sister company, which I call na Waymaker Engineering. So Waymaker Engineering is engineering services outsourcing. So what we do offer there is yun nga yung mga AutoCAD, computational fluid dynamics, engineering designs, structural fatigue analysis, anything that deals with the engineering designs within the mechanical, electrical, and structural. Those are the areas that we service to companies. Then there is this yung si the good place Korean Mart, which is in the food and beverage. Another one that, like, I call it a sister also because it complements each other. We have this Wood Grove Nature's Farm, so it's a farm located in Naguilian, La Union, that started back in 2015, pa actually, with fruit trees, guayabano, lemon, and calamansi that we are planning to be the source for the raw materials in the future to supply some products in the Korean Mart. So yun, merong parang four divisions yung Waymaker, I call it Waymaker Group.
Galing. Parang gusto ko na rin umuwi, magtayo ko ng ano ah. Miracle worker naman ang pangalan.
Kanta, miracle ano? Worker, yeah. Promise keeper.
Promise keeper. In the age of how business is run right now, sobrang solid nung concept ng collaboration eh. Katulad, I think ikaw, for you to be able to run it on your own, yung ganun kadaming entity, you know, maraming hindi mo siguro mga unnamed, no, na mga collaborators para mabuo yan eh. Hindi kasi pwedeng talagang mabuo ang isang concept na you are all by yourself. Instead of thinking of spending a lot of money, it's about who can I collaborate din eh, no? Pero business is always a risk, whether ikaw mag-isa o meron kang ka-partner, di ba? Meron at meron ka talagang, exposed ka talaga sa different kinds of risk. And talking about a risk, hindi ka ba kinabahan?
Yeah, before I answer the risk, no, shout out lang din kasi nabanggit mo yung collaboration kasi through this LSE program din sa 47, one of our classmates, si Gerald Galang, who is also now in, si Jay, who is now in Australia, he's in Melby also, is while I'm collaborating with him in the Waymaker Engineering. So right now we are cooking some projects for engineering designs, no? So with regards to the network that you develop, whether it's from the Ateneo LSE or from the other organizations, you really have to value them kasi collaboration, like you said, and I truly agree that these people, you cannot do it yourself, and you need people who has the same mindset and same interest, and that could help you to grow the business. Of course, kinabahan. I think just the thought of moving from Singapore, so living for more than a decade in Singapore and moving back sa Pilipinas with my whole family, it's really, really a big decision and risk kasi I was doing quite okay na sa aking company, no? Of course, there's no assurance as working in a company, pero at least I know that I could provide for my family because I still have the job. But deciding to leave the company, and not only myself, no, kasi my wife is also working with Thompson Medical, Thompson Hospital, so she's also enjoying a good employment. Both of us actually resigned at the same time, so we said, okay, this is going to be a leap of faith. One of the things na preparation that I did is actually attending this Ateneo LSE. So sunod kasi yung ginawa kong ano eh, in-equip ko yung sarili ko. So I attended the Ateneo LSE, and then I decided in 2018, nung December 2017, I've enrolled myself sa MBA in University of Manchester in UK. So I took an MBA class so to further equip myself. Yun yung ginawa naming risk mitigation doon, no? So we save up, of course, and then we equip ourselves to prepare for the battle ahead.
Sobrang importante ng preparation. In a lot of the trainings that I do also in the coaching is hindi mapapalitan ng patiently preparing yung impulsive excitement eh, na I'm ready, you know, I have the money, I think I can do it, and I'm just gonna go and wing it. Sobrang delikado nun eh. Maganda yung lesson na na-share mo na yun. Meron tayong mga kasama siguro sa community, they felt stuck ngayon sa work nila. And they don't know what sort of business, you know. But they know in their minds, I have to be like an entrepreneur somewhere along the way. Pero hindi nila alam, no? Hindi nila alam how to prepare. Ano yung pwede mong ibigay sa kanilang siguro practical insights, no? What can they do as a first step?
Yeah, I can relate to that, no, because I was once also like a wanderer. I always look up to people who had that kind of I would say yung guts to go for it, you know. And sabi nga nila YOLO, no, you'll only live once. So seize the moment. Like me and like many people probably has a lot of questions on where to start and what exactly I have to do. Because I have a million kinds of ideas, pero I don't know kung how do I execute them or is this the right one for me. You have to focus on, I think I would term that as know your skills. That's very important. So if you know yourself, you know what you're good at, you know what's your passion is. Like me, I'm engineer trained, pero meron din akong free spirit eh. Parang marami akong gustong gawin eh. Ayoko magpakahon. So that was like my starting point. So I've really a lot of tinkering na ginagawa na ano may pwede ko talagang gawin where I would really be happy. So know your skills, that's very important. So you have to assess saan ka ba magaling, ano ba yung passion mo, kasi that would really give you yung it would point you to the right direction where you would find na I think this is it, because magkakaroon ka ng ganung light bulb moment eh, na okay, this is it. And then you really have to be an incredible learner. You have to learn. I don't know how, so many times I have to say it. After attending the Ateneo LSE, it doesn't stop there. You have to continue learning, whether it will be in online class, kasi nga ngayon is we're virtual online class, or you find a mentor to share with you. Press Robert, no? Ang dami kong kinapalan ko talaga yung mukha ko sa before I moved back sa Philippines. Kinapalan ko yung mukha ko sa Facebook. I was messaging some people na entrepreneurs that are successful na dito sa Pilipinas, and I was telling them, sir, ma'am, I'm an aspiring entrepreneur. I wanted to build this engineering business in marine industry, and then I don't know how to start, so can you be my mentor? My intent for that is I wanted to learn. I wanted to learn, and I wanted to get as many mentors that I could get so that I learn fast. Kasi sabi nga nila, no? Either you learn from mistakes, your mistakes, or you learn from others' mistakes. So I'm trying to utilize the one that is less costly for me, which is learning from other people's mistake, so that I won't do that on my own business. To our friends, from colleagues, to know what you really want. It doesn't happen overnight, no. So don't be impatient, kasi don't jump on the gun so fast. Kasi itong mga ginagawang decisions natin, if you wanted to move back sa Philippines to set up your own business, there's a lot of opportunity cost nga na tinatawag dyan. You have to let go of your earning potential in to a something that you are uncertain, like going into business. Pero if that would make you happy, then I would suggest go for it. So you have to be patient. You have to learn fast. Learn everything that you can. You have to assess the risk, and you have to talk to your loved ones. So you really have to get their support. Kasi hindi lang to financial. What you're going through, this is not only about finances, no. So pagka iniwan mo yung trabaho mo sa Singapore and you move back sa Philippines, finances is one thing, pero ang pinakamalaking challenge mo dun is yung emotional tsaka yung mental, that you will questions. It happens to me, no. When we move back nga, biglang nag-lockdown, so we were like 3-4 months hindi kami makamove. Then you would see parang lahat, wala kang income at that time. Though you prepared for the rainy days, pero sometimes you can't help it, may mga questions ka sa mind mo na, am I doing the right thing, you know? So it's really important that you get the support from your family and friends on the decision that you will be taking.
Yun, that's a very, you know, powerful remark. Sobrang interesting ng move mo kasi hindi mo maalam na mangyayari yung pandemic, di ba?
Yeah.
Tapos talagang, you know, kung siguro kung alam mo yun, baka dinilay mo pa ng konti.
Pwede, yeah. If I knew na malalockdown lang kami dito sa Pilipinas, no, I probably had stayed pa sa Singapore.
Baka nandito ka pa ngayon kasi, di ba?
Probably.
The way things are going, di ba? Pero,
yeah, difference, it could be a different story. So,
pero, I mean, I think ikaw din siguro you would agree na yung na-experience mo, you know, pwede mo sabihin na challenges yon, priceless yun eh.
I fully agree on you that yung challenges na yun, that's, I'm enjoying it kasi I think without the challenges, the story in the future that I will be able to tell when I succeed won't be that so dramatic, you know. Pero when you experience challenge, that makes the story more sweeter.
Bibigay ko sa itong last few minutes, call to action. Meron ka bang gustong i-promote? Meron ka bang gustong i-highlight, you know, in any thing na ginagawa mo sa business mo ngayon? I'm gonna give you the time to share that.
First of all, thank you very much. It's really a privilege to be able to share. Since day one, when I stepped on attending the program, I met a lot of great people and I've learned from them. So those lessons that I've learned from the LSE program has really been very, very helpful to my journey. So siguro yun nga, call to action ko for all of us, those people that are watching this, to keep on persevering. You have the dreams in your heart, that's the first step. You have that great idea, that's really great. Like what Robert shared, start start planning, start creating a business plan. That's really important. It will take you far, and it will help you succeed in the plans that you have. So again, thank you very much. And just to promote lang yung business, no. So we for those people who are into Korean products, if you happen to be in Metro Manila, because we service Metro Manila and even actually Visayas and Mindanao, we do send products doon. Just visit us sa Facebook. Just type The Good Place Korean Mart. And then you could message us dun sa Messenger or in Instagram. Pero I would suggest sa Messenger would be much better kasi our people are very responsive. So, please do support. I think this is a really good platform also for us to support each other business. So let me know also if you have some products that you wanted to help, you need help for some displays that you think that we could display dun sa Korean Mart. I'm open. We are open for that. Anything that we could help for our business to grow, The Good Place Korean Mart can cater that. So thank you very much, Robert, and